In the last video, we have seen about permutations. In this video, let us see about combinations. What is combination? Combination is selection. What is permutation? Permutation is selection and arrangement, but combination is only selection. So let us see what is combination and let us see what is the difference between permutation and a combination. So A, B, C are the persons and any two are to be selected. In how many ways these two, any two can be selected? A, B can be selected, B, C can be selected, C, A can be selected. Only three ways, in three ways these two members can be selected from three members A, B and C. These three ways the two persons can be selected. If I say in permutation we have seen an example, there are two chairs, there are three persons A, B and C. In how many ways this can be arranged? First A, B are selected. If A, B are selected, A can be here, B can be here, B can be here, A can be here. So selecting A and B, this can be arranged in two ways. If B, C are selected, they can be arranged here B, C, C, A. Likewise A and C are, if A and C are selected, this can be arranged in, so this is B, so C, A, A, C. So if, let me write here again, if A, B are selected, they can be arranged here, A can be seated, B can be seated here, B can be seated here, A can be seated here. If B and C are selected, B can be seated here, C can be seated here, C can be seated here, B can be seated here. If A, C are selected, here A, here C, C, A. So selection, after that arrangement, this is what permutation means. Only selection, this is what combination means. For a given question, first we need to understand whether it is a combination or a selection. Let us say for a team member consisting of three team members should be selected from six persons. So this is a combination. Let us say three chairs are present and three members are to be selected from the six members and these three members are to be arranged here. This is what permutation. Based on the question, we need to understand whether it is a combination or permutation. So the formula used to calculate a number of combinations is, if three persons are given and two are to be selected, so how many did we get? 1, 2 and 3. So three combinations we got. If there are n objects are given and from this any r objects are to be taken, so how to calculate those number of combinations? Number of combinations is given by ncr, and it is this formula is n factorial divided by n minus r factorial into r factorial. So what is n factorial by n minus r factorial? Which is number of permutations, npr. Npr divided by r factorial is ncr. Some important observations are there here. NCR is equal to NCN minus R, and NCR is equal to, sorry, NCR plus NCR minus 1 is equal to N plus 1 CR. These two are to be remembered sometimes. Based on this we need to find the value of R if the in this type the question is given, and N value is given and we need to find the R value for this type. This two important observations are to be remembered. The combinations are solved using this, number of combinations are solved using this formula, n factorial by n minus r factorial into r factorial. So for this question, so there are three objects A, B and C, three objects taken two at a time. So three objects taken two at a time. So how to solve this? N is equal to 3, R is equal to 2. There are three objects taken two at a time. So number of combinations that can be formed by this is n factorial divided by n minus r factorial into r factorial. So n factorial is 3 factorial divided by 3 minus 2 factorial, which is 1 factorial into 2 factorial. So 3 into 2 factorial divided by 1 into 2 factorial. So 2 factorial, 2 factorial gets cancelled and the remaining is 3. So did we get 3 here? 1, 2 and 3. 3 combinations we got. Let us solve some problems on this combination, number of combinations. What is the number of ways choosing, number of ways of choosing 4 cards from a pack of 52 cards? So let us understand what are those playing cards. So in a pack of 4 cards consists of 52 cards. In this 52 cards, there will be 4 types. The first one is clubs, spades, diamonds, and hearts. Clubs, spades, diamonds, hearts. These clubs and spades are black in color. These two are black in color. And diamonds and hearts are in red in color. So these 4 are called suits. Suits of pack of cards. So club suit consists of 13 cards. Spades consists of 13 cards, diamond consists of 13 and heart consists of 13. So this is club is of this symbol. Every card of the club has this symbol. And this is diamond. This is heart and this is spade. So every card has its respective symbol. If you take a card of heart suit, this symbol will be present. If you take of spade, this symbol will be present on the card. So every suit of the card consists of 13 cards. One is ace, which has letter A, and one is king, queen, jack, and numbers ranging from 2 to 10. So 2 to 10 consists of 8 cards. Jack is 1 card, queen is 1 card, king is 1 card, ace is 1 card. So 9 cards. 2 to 10 is 9 cards. 9 plus 4 is 13. Total 13 cards are present. These 4 cards collectively known as face cards. Ace, king, queen, jack. These 4 cards collectively called as face cards. Here I have made a small mistake, which is these 4 are said to be special cards and not face cards. These 4 are said to be special cards. And from these special cards, this king, queen and jack are said to be face cards. Only king, queen and jack are face cards. And ace, king, queen, jack are special cards. From these special cards, king, queen and jack are said to be face cards. So there will be total 12 face cards and 16 special cards. So let us see now the question. The question is, what is the number of ways of choosing 4 cards from a pack of 52 cards? So what is n here? N and r, total number of objects is n is equal to 52. the number of objects taken at a time. Four cards are taken at a time. So R is equal to 4. So NCR, which is 52C4, is equal to N factorial divided by N minus R factorial, which is 52 minus 4 is 48 factorial, into R factorial. R is 4, so 4 factorial. So 52 factorial can be written as 52 into 51 into 50 into 49 into 48 factorial divided by 48 factorial into 4 factorial. 48 factorial, this one gets cancelled, and the answer will be, if we calculate, it will be 270725. In these many ways, the 4 cards can be selected from 52 cards. The next question is, we need to find what is N, what is R, based on the question. Number of ways of choosing 4 cards from the same suit. So there are, how many suits are present? Diamond, heart, spade, club. So there are 4 suits present. So in diamond 13 cards are present, in heart 13 cards are present, in suit 13 cards are present, in clubs 13 cards are present. From these 13 cards, 4 cards should be selected, which means the 4 cards should be of the same suit. So 4 cards are selected from this, or 4 cards can be selected from this, or 4 cards can be selected from this, or 4 cards can be selected from this. So this will be, from these 13 cards, 4 cards are selected. So there are totally 13 cards, 4 cards are to be selected from this. 13C4, 13C4, 13C4. So this is 4 cards from this, or 4 cards from this. So there is no relation between these two, diamond and heart, or no relation between diamond and spade, because all 4 cards are of same suit. So we need to add 13C4. In these many ways can be selected from diamond, but there are other suits also. In these many ways it can be selected from spades, in these many ways it can be selected from hearts, in these many ways it can be selected from spades. So we need to add all these combinations, 13C4, which will be equal to 4 into 13 factorial, which is n factorial, divided by n minus r, which is 13 minus 4 is 9 factorial, into r is 4 factorial. So the answer will be 2860 ways. In 2860 ways, 4 cards can be selected from the same suit. And next question is, number of ways of choosing 4 cards that belong to 4 different suits. So there are diamonds, clubs, spades, hearts. So there are 13 cards in this, 13 cards. From these 13 cards, one card should be selected. So a card can be anyone. So this is a combination. 13C1, from these 13 cards, one card should be selected. In how many ways it can be selected? In 13C1 ways, this can be selected. Clubs can be selected, 13C1. So here it is 1, because every card should be from different suit. No card should be of the same suit. So from every suit, only one card should be taken. So in how many ways the cards can be taken? We have seen in principle of counting. What is principle of counting? If first event can occur in M ways, second event can occur in N ways, third event can occur in N ways. So total events can occur in M into N into P. So here, first event, what is first event? Taking one card from taking one card from diamond, second event from club, third event is S, spade, and fourth event is hearts. Every event has its respective number of combinations. So we multiply 13C1 into 13C1 into 13C1 into 13C1. So if ace from this can be selected from diamond, and from club A can be selected, from spade A can be selected, from heart A can be selected. If king is selected here, ace is selected from club and ace is selected from spade, like that, any number of ways it can be selected. So how many number of ways it can be selected? 13C1 into 13C1 into 13C1 into 13C1. We have seen this in principle of counting, right? So the answer will be 13^4. What is 13C1? N factorial. 13 factorial divided by 13 minus 1, which is 12 factorial into 1 factorial. This is what? 13 into 12 factorial divided by 12 factorial into 1. 12 gets cancelled and the remaining is 13. So 13^4 is the answer. We need to understand this. Here all are added, but here all are multiplied. This is because there is no relation between this diamonds, hearts, spades, and clubs. There is no relation between them. Four cards should be selected only from one suit, but here one card is selected from one suit and other card is selected from other suit. So there is relation between all these. So this is multiplication and that is addition. Let us see another question based on combinations. A committee of 3 members should be formed. There are 2 men and 3 women. So there are 2 men and 3 women. A committee of 3 members should be formed. In how many ways it can be done? So there are 3 places, 3 vacant places. In how many ways it can be done? There are 2 men, 3 women. So there are 5 people. It can be done in 3 people, right? Sorry, 3 people we need to take from 2 men and 3 women. We can take 3 women at a time. We can take 2 men and 1 woman. We can take at our wish. So irrespective of men and women, we have 5 people. So from this 5 people, 3 should be selected. We can take in any order. So 5C3. From 5 people we are selecting 3 at a time. So n factorial is 5 factorial divided by n minus r, which is 2 factorial into r factorial. R is 3. It will be 5 into 4 into 3 factorial divided by 2 into 3 factorial. So 2 into 1, 2 factorial is 2 into 1. 2 2's, 3 factorial gets cancelled. And so in 10 ways the people can be, 3 people can be selected from 5 people. Second question, how many of these committees would consist of 1 man and 2 women? What does this question mean? In how many ways 1 man and 2 women can be selected? So 1 man can be selected from 2 men. There are 3 seats, 2 men, 3 women. From this, one man should be selected. One man should be selected from 2 men. And 2 women should be selected from 3 women. In how many ways this event can be done? This event can be done in 2C1 ways. What is 2C1? 2 ways. NC1 is always N. And this can be selected in 2 women from 3 women. Total there are 3 women. And from this 2 should be selected. This will be 3 factorial divided by 2 factorial into 1 factorial. So 3 factorial can be written as 3 into 2 factorial divided by 2 factorial into 1. So 3 ways. In 3 ways it can be selected. So event 1 can be done in 2 ways. And event 2 can be done in 3 ways. And there is a relation between these two. So we need to multiply 2C1 into 3C2. This will be 2 into 3, which is equal to 6 ways. This is how we need to solve the problems of combinations. I'll attach some practice problems in the description. Practice more problems on this permutations and combinations. It will be useful in solving the probability problems very easily. In the next video, we will see about probability. Thank you for watching this video. If this video is helpful for you, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.